Behind me, a couple of the most useful instruments in a chemistry lab. A gas chromatograph and a mass spectrometer linked together. Here's a question for you. What's the link between those instruments and this poppy seed bagel? All right, well, poppy seeds, where do they come from? Obviously from the poppy. And people also know that opiates, like morphine, come from the poppy. The seeds themselves actually contain very, very little morphine. On the other hand, the latex of the poppy, the juice that comes out when you score it with a knife, that contains morphine, codeine, and a number of other opiates, but the seeds do absorb some of that. Now, this can be an issue, because if you eat something that contains poppy seeds, the opiates in there, even though they're only in trace amounts, do get into the bloodstream. However, these instruments are so sophisticated that they can pick up those trace amounts. So first, what happens if one does a test of the urine to see if someone has consumed opiates is to do an extraction of the urine with ether, and that will then concentrate into the ether all of the organic compounds that are soluble in ether, and the opiates are. That then is injected into the gas chromatograph, and that separates these compounds, because there are dozens of compounds in opium. Each of those compounds then is injected into the mass spectrometer. What happens in there? Well, the compounds are bombarded by a beam of electrons, and these compounds break apart, and the instrument is able to analyze the fragments by their mass. And from that, we can put together what the original compound must have been. I'll give you an analogy. Suppose you have broken pieces of glass on the floor. You don't know what was the original substance from which these pieces came. But if you laboriously put together the pieces, you can come up with a glass or a vase or whatever it was. So with a mass spectrometer, by knowing how a molecule breaks apart into pieces, we can piece it together and come up with what the structure of the molecule was. And generally, one looks for substances of abuse. So for example, after an athletic event, when samples of urine have to be given, a chemist will do what I just described to you. And this can be a problem because if you've just eaten a muffin or a bagel with poppy seed, that can put enough opiates into the urine to give a positive test. Even though it's totally innocuous, it's not going to improve athletic performance. And this is why athletes are told that if they are going to engage in some sport where there will be urine testing after, they need to stay away from eating anything with poppy seeds, because our techniques are so sophisticated that they can pick up just trace amounts. Nothing wrong with eating the poppy seeds. Tastes good, and I don't have to give any urine tests. They're not required for teaching you.